So we'll talk about analog transmission today. We'll see the digital to analog. That means digital 1001 kind of signal or data element needs to be converted into the analog or sine wave like wave or data. So the digital to analog conversion is the process of changing one of the characteristics of an analog signal based on the information in the digital data. How we are going to do it? We'll see the following, that is the aspects to digital to analog conversion: the amplitude shift keying, ASK, FSK, that is frequency shift keying, and phase shift keying, and QAM, that is quadrature amplitude modulation. So what do we mean when we say digital to analog conversion? When we have a computer, it will understand, or a computing device, it is the going to understand only the digital data, this one, that is 1001. So any signal, whether it be an analog, if it is digital, that is very good. Otherwise, we need to convert the analog to digital and digital to analog. Why? If this is a sender and a receiver, now this sender wants to send whatever data it has to the receiver. So now it has data in digital format. You have to convert the digital data into analog, because this link, there is a link, and say it can contain analog data. We are not saying that you have a link which has or which can contain digital data. So let us assume that you have a link which needs to have a signal which is analog. So for that we require a modulator. What is modulator? We'll see about the modulator also. So digital data is converted to analog signal, and then the link sends it. But this system is understanding only digital data. So now we require a demodulator here, which can convert the analog signal into the digital signal so that receiver can understand it. There are various types of digital to analog conversion. First is your ASK, amplitude shift keying, frequency shift keying, and phase shift keying, PSK. If you combine amplitude with the phase, we call it as QAM, that is quadrature amplitude modulation. Let us understand few concepts first. Bitrate, as we have already seen what bitrate is. Bitrate is the number of bits per second. So for 1 second, how many bits we can see, say for this duration 1 second, if you have say 8 or say 6 bit, we call it as a bitrate. So you have 6 bit per second BPS. What is the baud rate? This is the number of signals element per second. How many single element? Now from this point to this point, we consider it to be one single element. If we have say 4 bit, we can have 4 bit in one signal, say 1001. So we say that the baud rate is 4. In the analog transmission of digital data, the baud rate is less than or equal to the bit rate in the analog transmission. An analog signal, let us take an example, carries 4 bits per signal, as I just suggested, say 4 bits per signal. So in one signal, it has 4 bits. So if 1000 signal elements are sent per second, find the bit rate, and we know that how this bit rate and baud rate are related. This n, which is s into r, what is this? We have r, which is the bits per signal element, 4. What is s? These are number of signal elements. N is unknown. We want to find the bit rate n. So this s and n and r, they are related by, because s, that is the number of signal element, is equal to the n, which is not known, that is the bit rate, by the r, number of that is bits per signal element, that is 4. So the bit rate is given by number of signals per signal element into number of signal element. Signal element will cancel, we'll get the bitrate. So it will be 1000 into 4, that is 400 BPS. You know that the bit rate is always in terms of BPS, bit rate, bit per second. Let us take one more example. An analog signal has a bit rate of 8000 BPS. This is bit rate. And the baud rate is 1000 baud. Baud is what? Number of signal elements per second. So how many data elements are carried by each signal element? How many signal elements do we need? We can just by knowing these units, we can easily find it out. That will be, here we have S as what? 1000. This is the baud rate. And we know that baud rate is nothing but the bits per second, that is the bit rate divided by the number of signal element. So now we can find out the R, that is we divide 8000 by 1000, that is 8 bits per baud. And we also need to know how many signal element do we need. So this is 8. How can we reach 8? 2 to the power 8 is 8. So what will be the number of levels? If we have 8 bits per baud, we are using 8 bits, so that will be 256. So we know that this R is equal to log base to L. These are the levels. And what is this R? This R is nothing but the number of data elements. So how can you get the data elements with respect to L? This will be L is equal to 2 to the power R. That will be, the levels will be 256, because 8 is the bits, number of bits per baud. So carrier signal. What is a carrier signal? Which carries? So you have a signal. Say this is your signal. This is the carrier signal. So your signal frequency may be less, or the energy may be less. So it may get attenuated. It will not reach to that distance. For that you have to use a carrier signal. You have to, this is a train. You are say a visitor or a passenger. So you take this train. So this signal puts itself onto the signal, and then the signal reaches to the destination, and the destination receives this passenger. The required bandwidth for analog transmission of digital signal is proportional to the signal rate, except for this frequency shift keying, in which the difference between the carrier signals needs to be added also. Carrier signal in analog transmission, the sending device produces a high frequency signal that acts as a base for the information signal. So this can be a base, or information signal can be like this. So this base signal is called the carrier signal, or also known as the carrier frequency. Digital information changes the carrier signal by modifying one or more of the characteristics. So digital information will change the carrier signal. What is this carrier signal that carries the data, or which carries your actual data or actual signal? So how you're going to get it? You're going to get it, or how you can change the carrier signal? We have various characteristics of a signal. Any signal can have amplitude, frequency, or phase. So you can change the amplitude, frequency, and phase. This is the amplitude shift keying, ASK. See, this is, say you have some baud rate, 5 signals per second. This is a bit rate, 5, 1, 2, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. Now this is a signal, one signal, then you have no signal, then signal, then no signal. So with respect to the amplitude, these are the amplitude. How we can get digital signal from this? Because this is what? This is analog, means this is an amplitude. So if there is amplitude, we say it is 1, otherwise we say 0. Here we have R equal to 1, S equal to N, and B is equal to 1 plus D into S. And FC is the central frequency. B is our bandwidth. B is our bandwidth. R, S and N, they are the bitrate and baud rate. So how to implementation of binary ASK? How are you going to represent it? This is your carrier signal. And this is what? What is this? This is your analog signal. Digital signal. This is your digital signal. This is your carrier signal. So now, you use a multiplier. You use a multiplier, or you can multiply these two. So for this zero, there will be no signal. Otherwise, there will be a signal. So these combined with this gives a binary ASK. These are zero. So with carrier signal, and this is the original signal, this is the actual signal which you want to send. You combine this is this original plus carrier signal, and this will be like this. Okay. So we add oscillator because we want oscillator with this, multiply them, and when we this is the carrier frequency. So when FC is multiplier or multiplied with the original signal, that is the digital signal, we can now send it through this. The waveform will be like this. So we have a, say an available bit bandwidth B of say 100 kilohertz. Bandwidth is what? 100 kilohertz, and it spans for 200 to 300. So what is FC? What are the carrier frequency and the bit rate if we modulated our data by using ASK with D equal to 1? So we know that for 200 and 300, 300 plus 200 by 2 will be 250. This is our FC. So the middle of the bandwidth is at 250 kilohertz. FC will be 250 kilohertz. Now let us see the formula. B is equal to 1 plus D into S. We'll use for ASK this formula. What is the D here? It is given as D equal to 1. S is what? S is the value which you know, N by R. This is N by R. What is N? What is R? So R is 1. So N will be, what? Because we know that 1 plus D into S, we have got it from here. What B is equal for this ASK, it will be B is equal to 1 plus D into S. So we have to find the S. We know the bandwidth, we know the D. We can find the S or the we can find the B, whichever is given. So we'll see in this particular example. So we place the values which are given. What are the values? The values are 2 into N by R. N is not known, we have to find it. 2 is there, R is 1, D is 1. Okay. So 2 into N by R, that is 2 into 1 N by 1 is equal to what? Bandwidth. Bandwidth is what? 100 kilohertz. It is 100 kilohertz. So N will be 50 kbps. This is the N. In a data communication, we normally use full duplex links with communication with both directions. So both direction communication, both can talk at the same time. Full duplex. So we need to divide the bandwidth into two with two carrier frequencies. We'll see the figure. So the figure will show the position of two carrier frequencies and the bandwidth. And the available bandwidth for each direction is now 50 kHz, which leaves us with the data rate of 25 kbps in each direction. What it is showing is, this is full duplex. So if this is 200 to 300, we are left with, because this has to be a full duplex. So the center, we have to take the center. What is the center? That is 250. So this 250 to 300 will be for say one direction. 200 to 250 will be for the other direction. So what is the center frequency for this? This end, say for this direction. We have FC as 200, 250 by 2, that is 225. So what this bandwidth will be? Bandwidth will be, B is, this was 100 hertz, kilohertz. It has become 50 kilohertz, right? So what data rate it would be? Again, we divided by 2. We have just known that the data rate for the previous answer, the previous question answer was 50 kbps. But we divide it one more time, that is 25 kbps. Okay, this will be bandwidth of full duplex ASK. Then we come to the binary frequency shift keying, analog to digital transformation. And we use the frequency shift keying. In what we do? What we do here? This is amplitude. Again, the baud and bit rate, we know these are the number of signals per second, these are the number of bits per second. So if the bit rate is 5, we have 5 bits per second. Baud rate is 5 because number of signals are 5, say. So with respect to the frequency, this is the frequency. And we change the frequency at 0. The frequency at 1 is different. 0 is different. For this, see, there are certain, because this is two frequencies now. One is this frequency, the other is this frequency. So for this, we have different computation. That is, for one frequency, it was S1 plus D. The other frequency, it was S1 plus D. We combine them. That is, S1 plus D plus 2DF. What is this 2DF? This is the difference of the central frequencies, or the F2 minus F1. 2df. So if r equal to 1, s is equal to n, and b is given by 1 plus ds plus 2df. You know all these values, right? So let us take an example. We have an available bandwidth of 100 kHz. B is 100 kHz, which spans from 200 to 300. What should be the carrier frequency and the bit rate if we modulate our data by using FSK, frequency shift keying with A equal to 1? Let us see. The problem is similar to the previous one, but now we are using the FSK. So the midpoint of the band will be at 250 as usual, and we choose 2 delta F to be 50 kHz. 2 delta F to be 50 kHz. So what it will be, D is 1. So 2S plus 2 delta F, let us take it as 50. So that will be 2S plus 2 delta F, that is 50 kHz is equal to 100. 50 goes here, that will be 2S equal to 50 kHz. So its S will be 25 kbps. N will be 25 kbps. S will be 25 kilobaud. Right? This is the implementation of DFSK. What we are going to do? We'll use a voltage control oscillator here. This is our digital signal. This is our frequency. So we combine these one with, so we add them. So the frequency will be higher at 1. The frequency is lower at 0. So we use this VCO to add the voltage control oscillator to the digital signal, and we get the BFSK. This is the multi-level FSK. If you have number of levels, then it will be L minus 1 to delta F, that is B equal to L into S here. We need to send data 3 bits at a time at a bit rate of 3 Mbps. So 3 bits at a time, say 0, 1, 0 we are sending. And bit rate is 3 Mbps, megabits per second. The carrier frequency is 10 MHz. Now calculate the number of levels, different frequency L, the baud rate and the bandwidth. See that we have 3 bits. We want to send 3 bits. So 2 to the power 3. So how many levels do we need? That will be 8 levels. The baud rate is simply S is given by N by R. What is N? N is nothing but the 3 megabit per second. Okay. So we'll use 3 by R. What is R? R is 3. So this will be 3 by 3. It is 1 megabaud. So what it means is that the carrier frequency must be 1 megahertz apart. That is, 2 delta F should be 1 megahertz. You have seen in the figure what was 2 delta F? That is the carrier frequency that must be 1 megahertz apart. So what will be the bandwidth? Let's use that formula L into. You have just seen that formula. L into S. So L into S. L is 8. What is this? 1 megahertz. So at 8 into 1, that will be 8 megahertz. So we'll show the oscillation of frequencies and bandwidth here. What is this B? B is equal to 1 plus D into S plus L minus 1 into 2 delta F, which can be given by L into S directly. So now the bandwidth will be 8 megahertz we have just seen. And we see that the F frequency varies, or the difference is 1 megahertz, so 6.5, 7.5. This is your central frequency that is given to be 10 megahertz. This is binary phase shift keying. Now we are looking at phase. And you can very well observe that this is our signal. And in this signal, as we reach to the change of signal, that is 1 to 0, it changes the phase. Again, when it reaches here, when it encounters 0 to 1, it will not go here, but it will change its phase. So this is given by, again, R equal to 1, S equal to N, B is equal to 1 plus DS. Bit rate is 5, but it is 5. This is how your signal will be seen. How we implement BPSK? This is our carrier signal. And this is our carrier signal, and this is our actual signal. That is the digital signal. So we modulate it. At every change of signal, we shift the phase. We shift the phase. For this, we again use the oscillator to the digital signal and multiply it. And ensure that the phase only changes at every bit change. This is QPSK, quadrature PSK, this phase shift keying and its implementation. So this is, now you have, if you have 2 bits, what you are going to do? 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, that is not 2 bits, but you are changing from, say, 0 and you are going to 1, that is 0 to 1. Then you are going from 1 to 0, that is 1 to 0. So in this, you know that this is the our carrier frequency and which change, we shift. And here we have all zeros, then a change, then 1, 1. So we have a carrier frequency and we can change. We can change the phase altogether. Say this is a phase change of minus 135 degree, minus 45 degree, 135 degree, 45 degree. So various shift or phase shift you'll see. So this is say 2 by 1 converter. This is 2 by 1 converter. This is this signal. So we have these are two signals. These are two signals, but they are changing. And we use the oscillator. Say some phase shifting is to be there, 90 degree. And we combine them. So we combine them to form a original signal. So we retrieve the signal. We need to find the bandwidth for a signal transmitting at say 12 Mbps for QPSK. The value of D equal to 0. For QPSK, 2 bits is carried by 1 signal. As you see, 1 signal carry 2 bits here. This is just a 1 signal. It is carrying 2 bits. This is 1 signal. It is carrying 2 bits. In QPSK, because this, why we have used 2 by 1 converter? Because there are 2 bits. You have to use 2 by 1 converter. So in QPSK, 2 bits is carried by 1 signal. 2 bits here. 2 bits. So this means now we have R equal to 2. R equal to 2. This number of signals are 2. So the signal, that is the baud rate, will be S equal to N by R. And you know what is R, that is 2. So 1 by R, that will go up. It will be 6 M baud. That is 12 by 2. That is 6. And what is the value of D? Now D equal to 0. With the value of D equal to 0, V and S will be equal to 6 MHz. The value of D equal to 0 is given. So this is the concept of constellation diagram. Because we are talking about phase and this is quadrature. So this is the amplitude of Q component, that is quadrature. And this is the in-phase carrier. And from here to here, this is the amplitude of one component. This is amplitude of Q complement. So amplitude with Q. This is the length of the amplitude with reference to the angle, which is the phase. This is how the concept goes for the constellation diagram. And we need to show the constellation diagram for an ASK, OK, BBSK, QPSK signal. We'll see this. This is ASK. This is BPSK. This is QPSK. Amplitude shift keying. Phase shift keying. Quadrature phase shift keying. So we have 4 here. One signal carry 2 bits. 3 constellations. So quadrature amplitude modulation is a combination of ASK and PSK. QA, that is quadrature amplitude modulation, is nothing but the combination of ASK, that is amplitude shift keying, and phase shift keying. This is the constellation of QAM, quadrature amplitude modulation. This is 4 QAM, this is 4 QAM, 4 QAM, this is 16 QAM. Analog and digital. Now we want analog to analog conversion, which is the representation of analog information by an analog signal. We have seen the digital to analog, or the analog representation of the digital signal, but now analog to analog conversion. This is the representation of analog information by an analog signal. So one may ask, why we need to modulate an analog signal? Why would require it? It's already analog. So why we need it? The modulation is needed if the medium is band pass in nature, or if only a band pass channel is available to us. How we are going to only utilize this band pass? For that we need modulation. So we'll use this amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, phase modulation. Analog to analog conversion, amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, phase modulation. This is the modulating signal. This is the carrier frequency. We combine them. So only this portion. Say if I combine this, let me overlay this modulating signal on this. Okay. And we'll not take the negative ones. No, this one. Only we'll take the positive ones. So this is how we get Okay. So if we modulate it, we'll get a signal of this type. This is the modulated signal, amplitude and modulation, because these are two amplitudes which are added, which will give us the result only this one. So we have the original modulating signal. This is the multiplier from oscillator, and we get the multiplier. So now we are BAM, amplitude modulation bandwidth, will be twice that of the bandwidth to B. Okay. So the total bandwidth required for the amplitude modulation can be determined from the bandwidth of the audio signal, that is to B. You have seen AM and FM in your radio, amplitude modulation, frequency modulation. The bandwidth of the audio signal is usually 5 kilohertz. So an AM radio station needs a bandwidth of how much? 2B, that is 2 into 5 kilohertz, so that will be 10 kilohertz. This is 10 kilohertz. So the total bandwidth required for FM now, frequency modulation, can be determined from the bandwidth of the audio signal, like 1 plus beta, 2 into 1 plus beta into B. What is this beta? Beta depends on the modulation technique, with a common value of say 4. This is frequency modulation. These are the frequencies. Now we modulate these frequencies, we combine these with respect to the frequency. So we get a FM signal. That is why FM is so clear. The frequency is high, energy is high. So this is the voltage controlled oscillator applied to the modulated signal. So we will get a frequency modulated signal. This will be equal to 2 into 1 plus B into bandwidth. So the bandwidth of audio signal, speech and music also, broadcasted or broadcast in stereo, is 15 kilohertz. So this FCC allows 200 kilohertz, that is 0.2 megahertz for each station. 200 kilohertz. If you tune into any FM radio channel and you see for next channel, there will be a difference of 200 kilohertz, that is 0.2 megahertz. So one will be 102.6 megahertz, other will be 102.4 megahertz. So this is the display of FM band allocation, 200 kilohertz. Now we come to phase modulation. This is the modulating signal, this is the carrier frequency. Now we try to modulate the phase. How we modulate the phase? We use this d by dt. Okay. This signal is subjected to the phase shift. We want this phase shift. That will be, again, phase modulation will be with respect to the phase. So that will be ppm is equal to 2 into 1 plus b into b. Again, we'll use this formula. So now phase modulation, see, there is no change of phase. What I am trying to say is, there is no change of phase here. Only the frequency with respect to the, which is representing the phase, is what you can see here. So the total bandwidth required for phase modulation can be determined from the bandwidth and maximum amplitude of the modulating signal, that is 2 into 1 plus beta into B. So these are few aspects of your conversions also, but I would recommend you to exactly see the details in the Frozen book or any other book you are consulting. So this is just an overview. This will help you in understanding the exact idea. So thank you so much. Take care.